Hey there digital friends, welcome back to Digital Visions, and in this video you're going to see about the soak test that is currently going on for the Moto One Fusion Plus. So today I received a new update for this soak test, which we can also say the second soak update for this One Fusion Plus. If you want to see what are the new features that we are getting with the Android 11 soak test, you can watch my previous video. So currently, as you can see, it is running Android 11 with December security patch. So let me show you the new update. Go to settings and check for updates. And here you can see this is the new soak test update, which waits about 466 MB with the January security patch. They didn't say much about this update over here, but as you can see the size, it's nearly 500 MB. So I think they have fixed all the bugs which we have in the soak test 1 update. So let me update it and I will update you regarding the bugs and the performance with this soak test update too. The biggest con in the first beta update is the battery, which we used to get 2 hours less than the Android 10 battery. So let's see whether they have fixed this or not. So as you know, the update takes time, and after updating I will use the device for a minimum of 1 day and I will update you regarding the bugs and all. So as it's downloaded, let me restart it. So now the phone is restarting and let's see what it says after it restarts. As you can see, the phone is starting. It's almost 2 months this soak test is running, and after reporting the bugs and all, this is the second update that we got in this Android 11 soak test. So it says finishing update over here. So it's completed. Let's see what it says here. As you can see, it says update complete. So I will use this update for 2 days and will update you regarding the performance and whether the bugs are fixed or not and all. So watch my previous video to know what are the bugs that are present in the Android 11 soak test. So let's go to the future now. So welcome back again guys. So currently I have used the device for 2 days and I will update you regarding the bugs and all. So let me first show you the settings here. So system update. So here as you can see, it currently runs on January patch. So someone in the comments asked me whether there is a change in boot animation and whether there is a decrease in the boot time or not. So let me show you that. So let's switch off the phone now and I will restart it and I will show you the boot time seconds it took to boot the device. So let me power on the device now. As you can see, I have kept a timer on the top left side. You can see how much seconds it took to power on the device. So new videos coming on regarding the custom ROMs on this Moto One Fusion Plus. So I will make videos on Android 11 and Android 12 new custom ROMs that you can use on Moto One Fusion Plus. So as you can see, it took nearly 25 seconds to boot up the device, and I have tried it 2 or 3 times and time is still the same. It took 25 seconds to boot up the device. And in the last video I forgot to show you the new app that we can use in the Android 11, that is the interactive wallpapers. So with this app you can get the new latest live wallpapers of the Moto devices that are released. So every time a new wallpaper with the new phone release, the app gets automatically updated and you can just download and apply the wallpapers. So simply download them and just click on apply or set wallpaper here, and that's it, the live wallpaper will be applied. So I forgot to mention in the before video, so I am mentioning it now. Regarding this soak test update too, the battery is back again and the battery is almost nearly close to the stock Android 10. As you can see, I am using currently from 100 to 76%, and you can see the screen on time of 2 hours and 37 minutes. So I didn't play any kind of games here, but if you use it in the normal usage like watching YouTube and browsing, then you will nearly get more than 10 hours. I think this is the final stable update, because one of the Brazilian user got the Android 11 update on his Moto One Fusion Plus with the same version number. So I think this is the version they will roll out to the Indian users also. So you can expect an update in the coming 1 or 2 weeks. In the earlier update, Netflix used to work good for me, but now it stops working in this update. So I don't know whether they will fix this or not. and it's working for some of the users and it's not working for some of the users. So now coming to the second stable update, I think this update is very stable. The performance has been improved, even the battery life has been improved. It has been very close to the stock Android 10, and even the RAM management is also been improved. So let me show you that also. Go to settings, system, developer options, and as you can see it is utilizing 3 GB of RAM here. In the earlier update it is used to utilize more than 4 GB of RAM. So the RAM management has also been improved in this soak test. So I think this will be the stable version and they will roll out to all the users. So regarding the UI bugs and all, I think they have fixed everything. Even the screen recorder works perfectly. So I think all the bugs has been fixed except that navigation bar bug. So let me show you that in the PUBG mobile game. So this bug is still there. I don't know why they didn't fix this update even we reported it. So as you can see here, there is a black space over the game here and that is not fixed, and you have to go to display and set your DPI values to 410 or lesser than that. So here is another pick for screen on time from 100 to 55%. As you can see, it's close to 5 hours. So finally, after 1.5 years of the device launch, this device is getting a first and last major update, that is Android 11. So this is the stable update that they are going to roll out. As you can see, they have started rolling out to Brazilian people also. So that's all for this soak update, guys. Thank you for watching these videos and subscribe for more videos.